Okay, so we're back to recording now. Sorry, it just kicked us off there for a little bit. Okay, so tell me about the steps you want to take to work on that real life problem then. What do you, how are you going to prepare the students for that lesson?
You mean for the circle four?
Yeah.
So I'm going to give them all the information, all the theory.
Yep.
The definition they need to know. And then they will work with a group to figure it out. Step by step.
Okay. Sounds good. Sounds good. All right. How did the kids react to the new style of teaching that you're showing? Have they given you good feedback? Like, oh, this is working. I like it.
Especially after I make whiteboard for them, I make the whiteboard for each of them. Oh, they like it so much.
Oh, yeah?
They engage more, better.
Yeah. Oh, very good. All right. Well, it sounds like you have a plan. Sounds like we have, we're coming up on the end of all this. And I think we can definitely say we're going to finish in time for the colloquium, the first one, which you and I signed up for, right?
Yes.
Okay. Sounds good. All right. So I'm going to look at, I'm going to stop sharing. Let's do this. Okay. I'm going to share my screen. Okay. Are you still with me?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going here to our list. Okay. So do you see how we have the incompletes here, which we still need to finish up, right?
Yeah.
So
I
we can
finish the three yet because I haven't write down the reflection yet.
Right. So we'll work on that. Do you want to work on that now? Do you want to work on the reflection now, or do you want to? What are you thinking? We can do it later.
Because we need to supplement our video, record the video to the reference too. After that, yeah.
Okay, that sounds perfect. We'll do that. Okay, and then I think that's it. All right, so let me pull up your ILP. Give me 1 second here. I have a special little folder for you. See? Yuhan.
Yeah.
All right. ILP.
Is it the phone or computer?
This is on my computer.
Oh, okay. Perfect. Yeah. So we can work on the reflection today, right?
Yeah, if you want to, sure.
So, Jenny, you see that? I changed the real life. This time, the circles through, I changed all the real life problems to the worksheet.
Okay. Let's see.
Yeah, because I import a worksheet I purchased from online and this week. So this time, the real life problem I changed to the worksheet, and then we can do the reflection.
Yeah. Okay, let's do that. Now you have here the driving question still talking about the real life problem. Should we change that?
Driving question?
See where it says?
To provide the problem solving. Oh yeah, change this for solving the provide students with the problem solving strategies for the problems on worksheet.
Okay, I'll let you type that then. Sounds like you know what to put better than I do right now.
Okay, see that just like use a worksheet.
Yep.
Okay,
and then we have, I just want to make sure we, since we changed that, I want to make sure we have anything else. What's going on?
Well, this one, I used the direct instruction to restitute step by step. I have calling for students, and this one, provide students organized model, organizational model, provide a problem solving strategy to help me, to help solve it.
Yeah. Where is that at? Right there. Yeah.
Solving the problem on the worksheet.
There you go. Yep.
Practice understanding and assess their ability to explain their process to their peer group and look at the thing, right?
Yeah.
And supervise students working with a worksheet and at first provide know all the organizational support and follow up with the organizational model. Yes, that's it.
Yeah, that looks good. That looks good. Okay, so let's look here. Evidence. There's your video. We'll post our observation video here. I'll put it up on YouTube and I'll put the link there for us. Okay, so let's do reflection. I'm going to let you type just so it, because it's a little hard for me to hear you. And I don't want to miswrite something that you want to put. So let's put... I'll type the questions and then you can kind of answer it. Same questions we've asked during the observation here.
Yes.
So. Okay, I'll let you answer that one.
So they show you in the class and
like what are you teaching?
Now I start to realize the importance of multi-representation of instructional for the instruction.
Right.
Multi-representation. So multi-representation is very important. For instructions, it's very important. It helps the students. It engages different kind of students.
Yes.
Different types. This one. Another one is the. I think teacher circle. Circle the class. When they work, and the teacher should be the work. When they work, teacher should help them when they have problems.
Yes, I agree. So let's write that too.
So teacher should engage in the group work too.
Yes.
Teacher should engage themselves. To group work so that it can efficiently help the students answer the questions.
Yes.
Help students to solve the problem.
Yes. Okay, let's try this. I'll write one here. All right, so what did you like about this video that you created versus the first one you sent me?
Because I did a lot of the foster the enforcement, I feel that student engagement is better.
Yes, I agree.
So, this time,
yes.
Also,
yeah, mention the whiteboards because that was really cool.
The cool whiteboard.
Yeah.
Whiteboard. And to help the group work. To help track the group work. To help students.
I would say engage and reflect. So they're engaged and they reflect on their own learning. Yeah. On the lesson, yeah.
Learning.
And the lesson, yeah. Yeah. That's good.
And the lesson. Yeah.
Yeah. Because when they can look back at their own work and then they look at other people's whiteboards and they look at theirs and they can make that connection of, are we doing it correctly or did they do something differently that we didn't try? You know, then they look at their work and evaluate what they did versus just say, oh, it's good. I'm done. I found an answer. You know, so that's good. Yeah. All right, let's see. I'm trying to think of, oops, sorry. Let's put that fix. All right, let me put this here. Oh, that's all we can put in there? Okay, then. Thought they would give us more room.
Yeah.
Yep, that's it. Oh, it drops down here. Okay, I see. All right, let's see. Let's just do a follow-up. So, okay, so what do you plan on using again? And is there anything that you would have changed with this last lesson? If there's nothing you would have changed, you just say, I'm good.
Okay, because I don't know what I can change. Not what I can change. And
well, I think with them, what worked good was your proximity, your positive reinforcement, your help with the students. I think the students obviously following rules as far as not getting up out of their seats and walking around. You know, you definitely had some more rules in place, so that would be something I would keep. Things that you could have changed, was there anything in the lesson that you kind of looked at and was like, that's okay, I could probably get a little better there? Or, I mean, you know your students better than I do. So is there anything at this point, like, that's the best you've seen them, so you're going to keep it at this? Any areas of improvement? Whatever you're thinking.
Yeah, I think so far it's good. I don't know which part I should improve. And but I do want to change update every week or every 2 weeks. And
okay.
I post the enforcement every week different. For example, the last week I did a parent call and. Last week, I did the homework task, and this week, I did posting forms are different.
Okay, so you did parent phone calls, homework passes. You also used proximity to students to control behavior.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's a proximity?
Proximity means you got close to them. You walked right up next to them.
Oh, okay.
And I saw that in the video, like you walked right to the students. Plus you were circling the room, so that's proximity anyways. Like, because you're not just behind your desk, you know, you're right out there in the class with the students.
Yeah.
You also mentioned you're going to keep the whiteboards.
Yeah.
Because the students really like that. Let's see. You're also going to keep peer collaboration.
Yeah, peer collaboration.
Okay, so any areas to change? You had mentioned that you want to update the class every couple weeks, you said?
Yeah.
Something like that. Maybe you can type it better, but update the class every couple weeks just to try to change it up a little bit. Change up the classroom environment, you know, so it doesn't get kind of boring. It kind of keeps it fun and moving.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else you wanted to change at this time? I mean, I'm not trying to tell you to find something bad. I'm just throwing that out there so I don't, you know, hear you out. I do too. I think that's it. Okay, perfect. So that's the reflection. The next time we talk, we'll go over inquiry 4 when I'm not sitting in a Starbucks with loud music behind me. So,
weekdays or weekend?
What, say it one more time.
You want the weekdays to work on weekend?
Yes. So let me go ahead. I'm going to stop recording here. So give me a second.